في ساحة للعلم كنا نلتقي، والحب والإخلاص زاد قلوبنا.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله، نحمده حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه، ونثني عليه الخير كله، ونصلي ونسلم على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين سيد الأولين والآخرين وإمام الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. الحمد لله الذي جمعنا في هذا المكان الطيب، الحمد لله الذي ألف بين قلوبنا على كتابه، ونسأل الله جل وعلا أن يرشدنا إلى الصواب، ونسأل الله جل وعلا أن يسدد أقوالنا وأن يسدد نياتنا، وأسأل الله جل وعلا أن يرزقنا وإياكم الإخلاص. أيها الإخوة المؤمنون، Dear respected brothers and sisters, we are going to talk about Quran, the virtues of the Quran, the importance of Quran in our life. And to be honest with you, when I was preparing for this lecture that I have delivered it number of times, I asked myself, shall I make it as an academic lecture whereby I follow a certain procedure and a certain structure, and then do I need to put a PowerPoint presentation in front of everyone? Do I need to have a paper in front of me or my laptop? Do I need to use my laptop? I said to myself, it will be more effective for me, for myself, and for the audience, just to speak up my mind and let the message comes from my heart in order to go to your hearts directly. Let me just be natural in the way when I speak about the Quran. I think it will be far more effective if the message is truly coming from the heart. My dear respected brothers and sisters, we are talking about the Quran. What is Quran? Quran is the book of Allah Jalla wa Ala, is the kalam of Allah Jalla wa Ala, the speech of Allah Jalla wa Ala, that He has spoken long time ago, and then He has revealed it. He commanded the pen to write the whole Quran, and then He sent it to the preserved tablet in a sama'i dunya, and then He sent it to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. And whenever Allah jalla wa ala send anything to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, he would speak again what He wanted to send to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Jibril, the angel Jibril, would listen to the Quran directly coming from Allah Jalla wa Ala, and then send it down to Jibril alayhi salam to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as he heard it from Allah Jalla wa Ala, exactly the same, with no change. Allah Jalla wa Ala did not accept anyone to interfere in the Quran. Allah Jalla wa Ala, it shows that the whole ummah enjoy what came from him directly. Allah Jalla wa Ala wanted this Quran to be his preserved words until the day of resurrection. Allah Jalla wa Ala honored this Quran. Allah Jalla wa Ala honored this ummah. Allah Jalla wa Ala honored Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam by sending to them his speech, his exact speech. And Allah Jalla wa Ala honored everyone by protecting this book only, and there is no other book that has been protected by Allah Jalla wa Ala. Any other book that Allah Jalla wa Ala revealed, as you know that Allah Jalla wa Ala revealed many books, the Torah, the Injil, the Zabur, Allah Jalla wa Ala did not decree to preserve those books, but Allah Jalla wa Ala decreed to preserve the Quran because Allah Jalla wa Ala loved this book the most, and Allah Jalla wa Ala put the most hidayah in this book, and Allah Jalla wa Ala wanted this book to be the light for the whole humanity, and Allah Jalla wa Ala wanted the whole humanity to follow this book. Allah Jalla wa Ala says in the Quran, Allah نزل أحسن الحديث كتابا متشابها. Allah Jalla wa Ala sent the best of speech, which is similar to each other. تقشعر منه جلود الذين يخشون ربهم. The skin of the people will shiver when they listen to the Quran, when they read the Quran, when they touch the Quran, when they let the Quran touches their hearts. ثم تلين جلودهم وقلوبهم إلى ذكر الله. Then their skin, their hearts will be softened by what? By the book of Allah Jalla wa Ala. Allah Jalla wa Ala says in the Quran, Allah Jalla wa Ala spoke about himself as he Jalla wa Ala is the light. Allah نور السماوات والأرض. Allah is the light for heavens, and Allah Jalla wa Ala is the light for earth. Allah Jalla wa Ala is the light of everything. Allah Jalla wa Ala sent to us part of his light. Allah Jalla wa Ala sent to us his light. What is his light? It is the Quran. And Allah Jalla wa Ala confirmed saying, وَمَنْ لَمْ يَجْعَلِ اللَّهُ لَهُ نُورًا فَمَا لَهُ مِنْ نُورٍ. If Allah Jalla wa Ala does not give anyone any light, Allah Jalla wa Ala, this person will have no light. That's why Allah Jalla wa Ala said, if you turn away from my guidance, if you turn away from my light, you will never see light at all in your life. You will live in dark for the whole life. Allah Jalla wa Ala says, وَمَنْ لَمْ يَجْعَلِ اللَّهُ لَهُ نُورًا فَمَا لَهُ مِنْ نُورٍ. Allah Jalla wa Ala confirmed this in the other ayah. وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكًا وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى. The one who turns away from my dhikr, from my guidance, from my remembrance, what will happen to him? He will have a miserable life now. And then وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى. We will resurrect him as a blind person on the day of resurrection. He would say, Ya Allah, why did you resurrect me as a blind person? Allah Jalla wa Ala will give him the answer. We have sent to you our guidance. You turned away from our guidance as a blind person, and we will turn away from you now. Allah Jalla wa Ala says in the Quran, إن هذا القرآن يهدي للتي هي أقوم ويبشر المؤمنين الذين يعملون الصالحات أن لهم أجرا كبيرا وأن الذين لا يؤمنون بالآخرة أعتدنا لهم عذابا أليما. Indeed, this book, this Quran guides to that what is better, better for the whole humanity, better for Muslims, better for non-Muslims, better in political life, better in economical life, better in social life, better in all aspects of our life. يهدي للتي هي أقوم. Better for people in the dunya, better for people in the akhirah, better for people in every aspect in their life. It is the nur. Then Allah Jalla wa Ala says, ويبشر المؤمنين الذين يعملون الصالحات أن لهم أجرا كبيرا. One of the main messages of the Quran is to give the glad tidings to those who follow the Quran. What is it? Those who follow the Quran, those who submit to the Quran, those who submit to Allah Jalla wa Ala by following to the Quran, what? They will have the Jannat. And all of us know what does Jannat mean. And all of us know what does fire of hell mean. That's why Allah Jalla wa Ala says, وَيُبَشِّرُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ الَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ الصَّالِحَاتِ أَنَّ لَهُمْ أَجْرًا كَبِيرًا وَأَنَّ الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ أَعْتَدْنَا لَهُمْ عَذَابًا أَلِيمًا. And he's also giving the bishara, the news for the disbelievers, that if you disbelieve in the Quran, if you disbelieve in Allah Jalla wa Ala,
a severe punishment, a severe torment will be waiting for you. My dear respected brothers and sisters, this is the Quran that we are talking about. It is the book of Hidayah. And as I told you, let me speak just my mind. Let the message comes from my heart. I don't want to follow an academic structure. My dear respected brothers and sisters, let us ask ourselves this question. We see many brothers, many sisters, Muslim brothers, Muslim sisters, feeling depression, feeling all types of difficulties, feeling that they want to commit suicide. They become suicidal. They don't enjoy this life. They have so many doubts about Islam. They have so many doubts about Allah. They have so many doubts about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. They have so many doubts in their life. Their life is full of misery. And then they are asking, what is the solution? Tell us what is the solution. Give us a guidance. And subhanallah al-azim. My dear respected brothers and sisters, if you have these problems, you should confirm one thing, that your relationship with the book of Allah Jalla wa Ala is so weak. I always say that if you are not enjoying Islam, Islam is a very enjoyable religion. It is a very enjoyable way of life. It gives you a different perspective. You will look to life differently. Yesterday we were walking at night, and just by walking at night with the brothers, we said, subhanallah, it is so enjoyable. You will look at the sky differently. You will look at the people differently. Whatever you face, whatever difficulties you face, whatever hardship you will be facing, if you are a true believer, you will look at that differently. How are you going to look at these things differently? If your relationship with the book of Allah Jalla wa Ala is strong. So if you do not enjoy Islam, it means that you are not enjoying Quran. If you are not enjoying Quran, my dear respected brothers and sisters, wallahi, whatever you do, you will never enjoy Islam. And if you do not enjoy Islam, wallahi, you will never enjoy your life. Let me know. In the most industrialized countries, the most civilized countries, as they say, people commit suicide. The average number of people who commit suicide in the UK is 4,000 people on a yearly basis. They find everything in their life. So why do they commit suicide? Because they have no light from Allah Jalla wa Ala. They are not enjoying their life. Subhanallah, they are liberal. They can do anything they want. They can do anything they want. Why do they commit suicide? Because they are not enjoying anything they do. And this means that there are lacking something. What is it? What is the real enjoyment? It is this book. The book of Allah Jalla wa Ala. The book of Allah Jalla wa Ala. That's why, if you really want to see the reality of this life, if you really want to see the light of Allah Jalla wa Ala, go to this book and wallahi you will see it, my dear respected brothers and sisters. Check yourself. What is your relationship with this book? And you will see how much Allah Jalla wa Ala loves you. You will see your status with Allah Jalla wa Ala. You will see your status. You will know about your status in Islam. Check your relationship with the book of Allah Jalla wa Ala. So those who suffer from depression, those who feel that life is now dark and they need to commit suicide, they are not enjoying it, just before you do anything of those things, just try to fix your relationship with the book of Allah Jalla wa Ala and then see what will happen to you. Wallahi, ya brothers and sisters, as I always say to people, learn how to read Quran and make sure you read Quran on a daily basis for 15 minutes loudly for 15 minutes and check yourself after 1 month. Wallahi, you will see yourself as a different person. Even if you used to hate Islam, because you are a Muslim just because your parents were Muslims. Even if you have doubts about Allah Jalla wa Ala, check what will happen to you after 1 month. And if you do not see the change, the real change in your life, you have to say to yourself, and I allow you to say and put it wherever you want to put it, that the Sheikh is a liar. He told us something that never happened. Wallahi, this Quran will change. This Quran will change the metal. This Quran will change mountains. This Quran will change disbelievers. This Quran will change everyone. This Quran changes individuals. This Quran changes societies. This Quran change. This Quran changes poor people. This Quran changes rich people. This Quran changes everyone. لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله وتلك الأمثال نضربها للناس لعلهم يتفكرون. If we were to reveal this Quran on a mountain, you will see that the mountain is cracking. This Quran destroys the mountain. Why? Out of the humbleness, because of the words of Allah Jalla wa Ala. This is the Quran that we are talking about, my dear respected brothers and sisters. This Quran, as we said, is the light of Allah Jalla wa Ala. And the light of Allah Jalla wa Ala is seen by Muslims and non-Muslims. Ya ayyuha an-nas, قد جاءتكم موعظة من ربكم وشفاء لما في الصدور وهدى ورحمة للمؤمنين. يا أيها الناس قد جاءتكم موعظة من ربكم وشفاء لما في الصدور وهدى ورحمة للمؤمنين. يا أيها الناس قد جاءكم برهان من ربكم وأنزلنا إليكم نورا مبينا. Allah Jalla wa Ala is saying, Ya ayyuhal nas. Allah Jalla wa Ala is not addressing believers only. He's not addressing Muslims. He's addressing who? He's addressing the whole humanity. What is it? قَدْ جَاءَكُمْ بُرْهَانٌ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ. A burhan, an evidence that has been sent to you from your Lord. Not only that. وَأَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكُمْ. We have revealed to you a nur, a light. From Allah Jalla wa Ala. That's why Allah Jalla wa Ala says, if he doesn't give you the light, you will have no light. In the other ayah, Allah Jalla wa Ala says, Ya ayyuhal nasu qad ja'atkum. Listen to the whole mankind. If there are non-Muslims here, listen to this. Stick to this book. Read it. Understand it. See what is there. If you do not see the light in there, then you are justified to be a non-Muslim. But if you see the light there and be honest with yourself, read this Quran with an open mind. If you do not see the light, then as I told you, you are justified not to be Muslim. And I am sure that if you read it, you will have no choice but to submit to it. Because Allah says to us, Ya ayyuhal nas, قَدْ جَاءَتْكُمْ مَوْعِظَةً. An admonition, a reminder came to you. Not only a reminder. مَوْعِظَةٌ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَشِفَاءٌ لِمَا فِي الصُّدُورِ. A healer for all the problems that you suffer from. All the heart disease, all the heart illnesses. They have a cure. Where is the cure? Is in the Quran. وَشِفَاءٌ لِمَا فِي الصُّدُورِ. And guidance for everyone, wahuda, and it is rahmah for those who submit to it. So if you want that rahmah from Allah Jalla wa Ala, submit to this book and you will see that it is giving you the real rahmah. My dear respected brothers and sisters, this is the book of Allah Jalla wa Ala that we are talking about now. If we want to talk about the Quran in our life, if we want to talk about Quran in our life and our duty towards the Quran, And what can we do? What shall we do? What we must do? First of all, my dear respected brothers and sisters, we have to believe in this book. This is the first point. We have to believe in the Quran, that the Quran is the exact word that Allah Jalla wa Ala to reveal to the whole humanity. This is the first point. We have to believe in it, we have to submit to it. Then we have to read the Quran and listen to the Quran. Read the Quran and listen to the Quran. My dear respected brothers and sisters, let us be honest with you. How many of us make sure that they read Quran on a daily basis outside the salawat? How many of us do that? Very few. I conducted once a survey and we found that only less than 20% of the practicing people read Quran on a daily basis. These are the practicing people outside the salah. How many of us make sure that they read the book of Allah Jalla wa Ala from cover to cover? And when they finish it, they go back again and read it from cover to cover outside the month of Ramadan. We found that, subhanallah, just around 10%, less than even 10% of the practicing people complete the Quran outside the month of Ramadan. So the question is, do we read the Quran on a daily basis? In a loud voice, and I am insisting on a loud voice, for 15 minutes. And when we read the Quran from the beginning, we continue until the end of the Quran. And then we go back again, because we need to look at it. As Allah Jalla wa Ala says, the Quran is a shifa. We need to consider the Quran and take it as a real healer. What does that mean? Imagine yourself, my dear respected brother and sister, that you have a diabetes problem and you have to have a medicine, everyday tablet, pills every day. And if you do not take them regularly, you will suffer the consequences of your illness. If you do not read Quran on a daily basis, it means that you did not take the daily Iman tablet that preserves your Iman, that preserves your Islam. As the daily tablet for your diabetes is going to preserve your health, this will preserve the real health, which is what? Al-Iman, Al-Islam, the love of Allah Jalla wa Ala, the attachment to Allah Jalla wa Ala, being connected with Allah Jalla wa Ala, my dear respected brothers and sisters. This is the first point. Do we believe in the Quran? Do we read the Quran? And then, when we read the Quran, do we understand what we are reading or not? Do we really understand what we read or not? My dear respected brothers and sisters, let me ask you just a simple question. All of us read, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ اللَّهُ الصَّمَدْ لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ كُفْوًا أَحَدْ. Do all of you understand what Allah الصَّمَدْ mean? This is a verse that we always read. Every single Muslim knows this. Do we know what does it mean? Okay, and we always read, and we always hear the Imam reading, سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى. What does غثاء أحوى mean? We read, والعاديات ضبحا فالموريات قدحا. What is this? What is this? Arabic? English? What does it mean? We know that it is Quran. We know that it is the book of Allah Jalla Ala. What is its meaning? This is in Arabic. It is not in English. It is not in Chinese. It means that we are not putting enough attention to know the basic meanings of the Quran. And that's why there are so many things that have been mentioned in the Quran that we are unaware of them. Al-Hasan ibn Ali mentioned a very interesting thing about the Quran. He said, when the people, the Sahaba, used to receive the book of Allah Jalla wa Ala from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they used to treat it as messages from the one whom they love the most. Please, my dear respected brothers and sisters, let us think about this. They used to treat the Quran as messages from the one whom they love the most. I said to the brothers and the sisters, imagine that you are newly engaged, a brother newly engaged to one whom he wanted to get married to. And the sister one time sent him a text message. For whatever reason, he could not open it. Wallahi, he will not go to bed unless he is able to read what she has sent to him. Wallahi al-azim. And I challenge anyone who can go to bed without being able to read and understand what his fiance or his wife has sent to him. Same thing with sisters. And subhanallah, what will be in the message? It will be, how are you? I missed you. Something like this. And subhanallah, all types of guidance, all types of rahmah, all types of benefits in the dunya, in the akhirah. The real love is sent in this book, and we don't know what we read. We don't know what we read. In fact, my dear respected brothers and sisters, the fact that proves that we do not know what we read. Listen to people when they read Quran. They make hundreds of mistakes. Wallahi, they make tens of mistakes in just one verse. Recently, I was in Saudi Arabia. This is Saudi Arabia, the Muslim country, in Riyadh, in the heart of the Muslim countries. And I sat down after my sunnah. The man next to me was reading Quran. So I started to listen to him. Subhanallah, he made so many mistakes in the ayah. I asked him, I said to him, please, can you repeat what you are reading? Then he started to read. And then he said, oh, that was a mistake. Oh, that was a mistake. That was a mistake. In just one single line, he made 4 or 5 mistakes. And then when he put attention, his reading improved. His recitation improved. Why? Because if we read, we read heedlessly, without putting attention to what we read, without understanding what we read, and that's why we make so many mistakes. Until now, I remember that person whom I prayed. I sat next to him, and he was reading from Surah Ali Imran. زين للناس حب الشهوات من النساء والبنين والقناطير المقنطرة من الذهب والفضة والخيل المسومة والأنعام والحرث ذلك متاع الحياة الدنيا والله عنده حسن المآب. Then Allah جل وعلا says, قل هل أنبئكم بخير من ذلكم للذين اتقوا عند ربهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار وأزواج مطهرة ورضوان من الله والله بصير بالعباد. Shall I tell you about those who love the dunya most? This is their equalities. والله بصير بالعباد. Then Allah جل وعلا said, الصابرين والصادقين والقانتين والمنفقين والمستغفرين بالأسحار. The truthful people, the people who those who give sadaqah, والمنفقين, those who give sadaqah, those who make istighfar at the third part of the night. He read it like this. Those Arabs, they can understand what I'm talking about. He read it, الصابرين والصادقين والقانتين والمنافقين والمستغفرين بالأسحار. I looked at him. I said, brother, can you read it again? He read it again. والمنافقين والمستغفرين بالأسحار. I said, yeah, brother, read it again. والصابرين والصادقين والقانتين والمسلمين والمنافقين. يا brother, look at it, read it again. Then he read, والصابرين والصادقين والقانتين والمنفقين. I was reading it, والمنافقين. I made the منافقين next to the righteous people. I made the منافقين next to those who are having patience, those who make استغفار at the third part of the night. He said, oh, استغفر الله, sorry. I said, don't say sorry to me. You need to make استغفار before Allah جل وعلا. This is how we respect, or some of us, how they respect the book of Allah جل وعلا. They read it and they are unaware of what they read. So that's why we say, you need to read. We need to read, and we need to understand what we read, the basic meanings of what we read. And then after that, what do we need to do, my dear respected brothers and sisters? We need to practice what we read. One time Umar ibn al-Khattab, he became angry from one of his workers, and he was about to go to him. You know, Umar ibn al-Khattab is a very strong person. He said, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, Allah Jalla wa Ala says, Wal'afina anil nas. He said, Astaghfirullah, I pardoned you. Then he said, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, Allah Jalla wa Ala says, Wallahu yuhibbu al-Muhsineen. Allah likes the Muhsin. He said, go, you are free. Subhanallah. This is how they were reacting. This is a simple example on how they were reacting when they listened to the Quran. We need to put the Quran into our practice. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud says, when you hear that Allah Jalla wa'ala says, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, listen carefully, because it's Allah Jalla wa'ala is about to tell you certain instructions that you need to follow. And that's why Allah Jalla wa'ala says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَتْلُونَ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ وَأَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَأَنْفَقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ سِرًّا وَعَلَانِيَةً يَرْجُونَ تِجَارَةً لَنْ تَبُورَ. The scholar said, يَتْلُونَ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ means they read it and they follow it. Not just they read it without following it. That's why Allah Jalla wa'ala mentioned the recitation of the Quran before even establishing the daily prayers and giving the sadaqah, because it is everything. My dear respected brothers and sisters, we can continue on and on about the Quran and about the importance of the Quran. However, as I was speaking about our role and what shall we do towards the Quran, let me just put it in other words. My dear respected brothers and sisters, let me put it in other words. First of all, you need to check yourself and evaluate your relationship with the book of Allah Jalla wa Ala. This is the first step. I ask every single one of you with a revert who does not know how to read Arabic, or an Arab person, I ask them to take a copy of the Quran. First of all, open the last part of the Quran, Juzu 30. Yes, Juzu Amma, which should be read frequently. And just open it randomly and then read. I opened here. وَيْلٌ لِكُلِّ هُمَزَةٍ لُمَزَةٍ الَّذِي جَمَعَ مَالًا وَعَدَّدَهُ يَحْسَبُ أَنَّ مَالَهُ أَخْلَدَهُ. First of all, not necessarily to memorize it. Just check the first step. Do you read it? وَيْلٌ لِكُلِّ هُمْزَةٍ لُمَّزَةٍ الَّذِي جَمَعَ. Do you struggle when you read this or not? If you struggle, with all due respect, and you have been Muslim for years, you are a bad Muslim. You are a bad Muslim, and that is the first step to correct yourself. Because as they say in management, in order to correct yourself, you had to admit your mistakes. If you do not realize What mistakes you are committing, you cannot improve. You cannot change yourself. So that is the first step. Do you read it like this or not? The last juz of the Quran. If you read it fluently, then take the whole copy of the Quran and open randomly. Read.
إِنَّ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ وَمَا خَلَقَ اللَّهُ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ
fluently, like this. Not necessarily from your memory, but by reading it. Do you read it like this or not? So, if you don't read it, then you have to draw a plan for yourself. The first step in that plan is to be able to read the whole book without many mistakes, without struggling fluently. This is the first step. Yes, your brothers, sisters, this is the first step. How long do I need to do this? I will give you not more than 1 year. Not more than 1 year. You can do it in 1 year. And during that year, you have to memorize the last juzo of the Quran, juzo amma, in that year. How do you do it? There are many converts who find it difficult to read Quran. Let me just make it very simple. You know Surah Al-Fatiha. Surah Al-Fatiha, you must memorize it by heart. What you need to do is take a tape or ask anyone. Let him teach you Surah Al-Fatiha. Please listen to this. Let the person read in front of you. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. And repeat after him. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. No, repeat again. Repeat it even 1,000 times until you are able to read it properly, until you are able to recite it fluently. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. We don't want Muslims anymore to read Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. This is not Quran that Allah Jalla wa Ala revealed. If I make a silly mistake in English, everyone will laugh. While we pray behind imams, they make hundreds of mistakes in the Quran. There are still imams who read غَيْرِ الْمَغْزُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا الظَّالِّينَ. And no one laughs. No one ponder upon this. No one correct this because we accepted this. But if someone would say any English word wrongly, everyone will laugh. Subhanallah. We laugh because people make mistakes in English and we do not consider it at all any problematic to make mistakes in reciting the book of Allah Jalla wa Ala. Do we honor our language more than we honor the book of Allah Jalla wa Ala? So this is the first step. So read it, repeat it even 1,000 times. And then go to the second verse. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. No. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. I can't do it. Repeat it even 1,000 times. My dear respected brothers and sisters, when you repeat the Quran, are you wasting your time? Is it a waste of time to repeat the Quran? Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim has many, how many letters? How many letters are there in Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim? 19. What does the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say? In Hadith Ibn Mas'ud, all of us know this hadith. من قرأ حرفا من كتاب الله فله به حسنة لا أقول ألف لام ميم حرف ولكن ألف حرف ولام حرف وميم حرف. The one who reads a harf from the book of Allah Jalla wa Ala, he will get what? One single hasana. And each hasana will be multiplied by what? 10. So he will get what? 10 hasanat. When he reads Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, he is reading 19 harf. 19 hasana. No, 190 hasana. 190 hasana. Just by reciting what? Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Brothers and sisters, how long does it take to recite Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim? 5 seconds?
maybe 5 seconds.
On the day of resurrection, the kings, everyone in the world will be begging one hasana. The most richest person in the world will be begging everyone he sees for one single hasana. Ikrima, the famous student of Ibn Abbas, when he came to this verse, يود المجرم لو يفتدي من عذاب يومئذ ببنيه وصاحبتي وأخيه. He said, on the day of resurrection, the person will pass by his wife, will pass by his son. He will grab his son. He will say, oh my son, what kind of father I was for you. The son would say to his father, you were the best father for me. The father would say, as I was the best person for you, the best father for you, I sacrificed everything for you. Just give me one hasana today. Just give me one hasana today. And the son would say to his father, sorry, my father, I can't give it to you. Subhanallah, one single hasana. And by reading Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, you are getting what? 190 hasana. Once you repeat it in order to learn Quran, repeat it 100 times, how many hasanas you are going to get? And you are learning Quran. Then keep doing this. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, until you are able to read it fluently, as Allah Jalla wa Ala wants it. Then move to the last juzu of the Quran. It starts from قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ, or even قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ. Do I read it like this or not? Or قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ. No. 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 This is not what Allah Jalla wa Ala revealed. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ until you perfect it. And then move and keep moving. You will see, my dear respected brothers and sisters, you will see yourself. If you keep doing this, within 1 year only, if you spend on a daily basis around half an hour maximum, I'm not saying you spend 10 hours. No, half an hour maximum, you read the Quran as I told you, you will see that by the end of the year, your tongue, your ear, your mind is able to read Quran fluently. So that is the first step. Then I advise all of you, my dear respected brothers and sisters, I advise all of you, mashallah, all of you are young. I advise you to memorize the book of Allah Jalla wa Ala. I advise you to memorize the book of Allah Jalla wa Ala. My dear respected brothers and sisters, my dear young brothers and sisters, don't miss this chance. Wallahi, you will never get something as memorizing the book of Allah Jalla wa Ala. Wallahi, if you become old, wallahi, you will regret that you did not memorize the book of Allah Jalla wa Ala. You will say to yourself, as I always say to myself, as all elderly people say to themselves, wallahi, I wish if my parents were beating me up and forcing me to memorize the book of Allah Jalla wa Ala. So I become a hafiz now and I can read the book of Allah Jalla wa Ala at any time, at any point. So before you reach to that point, just have a plan to memorize the book of Allah Jalla wa Ala. Don't say that it is difficult. Wallahi, you can achieve it. There are many people who started, they do not speak Arabic fluently, and then they became hafiz of the book of Allah Jalla wa Ala. And give yourself maximum 5 years. 1 year to be able to recite Quran fluently, and 4 years to be able to memorize, 1 year to be able to read Quran fluently, and 4 more years maximum, if you are sincere, truthful, consistent, you will be able to read, to memorize the whole book of Allah Jalla wa Ala. And even elders, if there are some elders, we know some people who started to memorize the Quran when they were at the age of 60. And they managed to complete it by the age of around 70, before the age of 70. Those who are looking for rewards from Allah Jalla wa'ala, they can get it. So have a plan for yourself. And along with that plan, my dear respected brothers and sisters, on a daily basis, I advise all of you to carry a book of the carry a copy of the book of Allah Jalla wa'ala with you. Carry it. Now we have the smartphones, it is there. Have a copy that have the Quran and the translation of the Quran. And whenever you have a time, and instead of just going using public transportation, people, I see Muslims, they sit like this. Subhanallah. And they don't take either their smartphone or a copy of the Quran, and they just look at it and read. Why? Why are we a nation that wastes the time while we know that the time is the real investment? Why do we do like this? Because one of the main reasons, we do not have a vision. We do not have a plan. And you young people, don't do this mistake. Have a high ambition. One of those ambitions that you should have as a young person is to memorize this and to know the basic meanings of this. I hope that all the brothers and sisters can have this commitment. I don't like just to give a fiery speech with no action point. I would like all of you to have a promise, to have a pledge. Seriously, my dear respected brothers and sisters. First of all, in a year time, and Ramadan is coming, inshallah, in less than 2 months. It should be the starting point. In fact, you should start from now. In a year time, we should start by learning how to read Quran fluently. And for those who are non-Arabs, non-Arabic speaking, I would like to take a pledge from them to memorize the last juzu of the Quran and to be able to read the rest of the Quran fluently. Can I take that pledge from you? Who is ready for that? Who is ready for that, my dear respected brothers and sisters? When we give lectures in big gatherings like this, the organizers, they ask us to raise funds for the organization. Oh, who pledge £10,000? £10,000. You will go to Jannah if you pledge £10,000. Something like this. Subhanallah. We need to raise the real fund, the fund for the Akhirah. So I want to take a pledge from you. Who is going to, from the non-Arabic speaking people, who is going to learn how to read the Quran fluently in a year time and to memorize the last juzu of the Quran only? To start with, who is going to do this? Who is going to do this? Promise. Promise. Allah is your witness. Now, the other promise from the young people. Seriously, wallahi, ya brothers and sisters, take it from my heart, from the bottom of my heart. Wallahi, memorize the Quran. And you will be, wallahi, you will see light. You will see life differently. You will enjoy your life and you will be so grateful to Allah Jalla wa Ala that He has given you the ability to memorize Quran. You will never regret. And I am telling you, if you do not memorize Quran now, whatever you achieved in your dunya, whatever you achieved in your akhirah, you wallahi will regret. Khalid ibn al-Walid, the great commander of al-Islam, they said that he fought more than 1,000 battles. In one battle, he killed more than 100 people. 9 swords were broken in his hand in one battle. Khalid ibn al-Walid, when he was on his deathbed, he took the Quran and he said, Subhanallah, Ya Allah, forgive us. We neglected your book. This is who? Khalid ibn al-Walid. Sayfullah al-Maslul. He said, Ya Allah, forgive us. we did not put attention to this book. So, before reaching that point, and you are not going to achieve what Khalid ibn al-Walid achieved. So, what to do? Again, I want a pledge from young people to memorize the Quran and to have a plan to memorize the Quran in 4 years. Who is ready for that pledge? Come on, brothers. Come on, sisters. Who is ready? Ready and promise. Have a plan from now, not just like this. Who is ready, inshallah, in 4 years to memorize the Quran? Inshallah, promise. And the last message before we conclude, it is a message for non-Muslims. It is a message for non-Muslims. Non-Muslims might not like Muslims. You might not like us. You might not like Islam. You might say Islam is a barbaric religion, is a backward religion, is an extreme religion, is you name Islam whatever you want. I want you to think about two things. The first question is, where are you going to go after you die? This is the first question. Where are you going to go after you die? Then the second question, have you ever read this book? I am claiming that all non-Muslims who do not read Quran are misguided. All non-Muslims who do not read Quran, they went astray. I claim strongly that we are Muslims, are on the truth, and any non-Muslims on the falsehood, because they do not read this. I claim that this is the truth. This is a claim. It challenged me. I want any non-Muslim to challenge this. This is between me and you. Before you challenge me, go and read it. Go and read it. If you do not see the light, if you do not see the truth, then let us have an open debate. If you want to know whether I am extremist, whether I am radical, whether Islam is a barbaric religion, whether Islam is so and so, first of all, be honest with yourself. And there are many honest people. Just read this book and see the message there. Forget about what the media says. Forget about what I say. Forget about other people. Forget about the whole world. Just to check yourself, ask yourself the first question, where are you going to go after you die? And then check this book. Are you going to find the answer in this book or not? This is my message to them. This is my message to the whole humanity. Because this book has been revealed as a mercy for the whole humanity. And the media just asked me, what is your message? And this is our message. This is our message. We want goodness for every single one on this globe. We want the best for every single one in the whole universe. We want the best for Muslims. We want the best for Christians. We want the best for Jews. We want the best for atheists. We want the best for America. We want the best for Africa, we want the best for every single country, for every single individual. What is the best? This is the best. And we make it clearly, what are we calling for as Muslims? Call us whatever you want to call us. We are calling the whole humanity to endorse this book. This is our message. As simple as this. We have no message other than this. We want the whole humanity to endorse this book. And we wanted to make it clear. You will live in dark if you do not endorse this book. And if you know about this book and you do not endorse it, the God, the Creator, the Lord, the controller of everything, the one who has the control over everything, the Lord, the Master of the whole universe, will send you to the hellfire after you die. As simple, blatant, clear as this. This is our message. I ask Allah Jalla wa Ala to make us among those who connect themselves to this book, who learn this book, who read it day and night, and learn it, and follow it, and take it as a mercy. We ask Allah Jalla wa Ala to make this book as the spring of our hearts, the light of our eyes, the coolness of our eyes. We ask Allah Jalla wa Ala to guide us with this book, to guide the whole humanity with this book. We ask Allah Jalla wa Ala to forgive us because of this book. We ask Allah Jalla wa Ala to make this book, to make this book to intercede for us on the day of resurrection. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Wa barakallahu fikum.